Hi, today we are going to talk about the difference between user and traffic acquisition reports in Google Analytics 4. Then we'll look a little more closely at how each report can be utilized to see where your website traffic is actually coming from. So user acquisition shows user engagement that's specific to new users and can be used to see what originally brought the user to the site. In contrast, that traffic acquisition is going to show data for new and returning users, and will show campaign information for the most recent sessions that brought them to the site. Okay, so let's look at those reports. So I'm going to go here to reports, then down to lifecycle, and click on acquisition. And under here we have our two reports, user and traffic. We'll start out at the user report today. Okay, so here's your user acquisition report. Not too many filters at the top here, but we'll go over each one how you can use it to change your report for your needs. You have your date range up here. Make sure you have the one that you want. I'm just going to keep this as is for now, but you can just select the two dates that you want and apply it. Then you can add a comparison to your report and click here. It's going to look like this. One thing to note, the add filter is going to look just like this. The only difference is that it says build filter instead of add comparison up here. So just something to take note of, make sure you double check that and have the right one when you're adding it. So I'm going to add my comparison. So let's say we want to see a specific age range in here and compare that to our total new users. So we'll scroll down here to demographics, age, we'll just do 18 to 24 for now. I'm going to hit OK. And you can add up to 5, just something to note here. I'm going to apply that. Now we have our 18 to 24. Versus our, all of our users here. So now I'm going to get rid of that. I'm just gonna exit out right here. And then I'll X out of here. So our add filter again is gonna look very similar, just says build filter up here. We'll do that same filter. I'll do age, 18 to 24, and now this is gonna look a little different since it's adding a filter to the total acquisition. And now we're looking at it for all users. Okay, so I'll get rid of that filter on all of our data. So next up, you can look a little bit more specifically at the breakdown of all of your users if you scroll down. Right now it's going to default to the default channel group, but you can change that forever you need. Say you have specific campaigns you want to look at, you can click that and it's going to show a breakdown of all of your campaigns. But we'll go back to that default channel group. One thing to note is that you can scroll down here as well. It's gonna be a scroll through there. You don't need to click to another page or anything to look at those conversions or revenue. Just something not to miss there. And then if you have more rows that you need to look at, you can always add more. Right now we just have 10, so I'm gonna stick with 10 there. But a very helpful way to see all the specifics here, all of your new users, all of your engaged sessions. Another great thing that you can do here is you can add a secondary dimension to the data. You can get more specific here. So you want to add a custom filter, you can add that. Say you want to look specific demographics, again, you could just look at age and compare that to what everything. So now our direct is being filtered out by age. Now we're gonna have many more rows. So say you wanna do up to 50 so you can see everything at once, you can add that. Now we got that breakdown for ages in each of our default channel groups. Okay, now we're gonna move on to the traffic acquisition report. This is going to be very similar to your user acquisition report. Again, the difference is that this is users by session and it's taking into account new and returning users. Again, you can add comparisons, just like how we did with that user acquisition. And you can also add a filter. Same thing again as the user acquisition. Don't forget to have the date range that you want. That's a common problem or misstep that we see where people just forget to change the date range, then the data looks off, and then it's a simple misstep, but one to always double check. So now we can scroll down. And again, we have our default channel group. You can add another dimension. It's always going to default to the default channel group, but you can always change it to whatever channel you need or the different source. Again, you can scroll down here, see more data, change it to however many rows you need. And that is the basics of your two acquisition reports. Very simple. You can make it pretty granular with what you want to see. Very helpful and user-friendly. But if there's anything I didn't touch on or you want to know more about, feel free to leave us a comment. And maybe we'll make another video in the future getting a little more granular about these reports. Thanks.